Alright, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to a new episode of Travel with CK. As you all know, I am Cowboy Kalu, joining you here every week, bringing the most incredible things about our country, Sri Lanka. So today, you are joining me on the channel A6, and I know that we have a live audience here right in front of me, and all of you joining me from Facebook Live and YouTube Live. Hello, 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 how are you guys? I hope you guys are doing really, really well. So on that note, if you all remember, we were last week, I took you all to the Hambantota Maitharajapaksha Memorial International Airport, but unfortunately I was the only one there, and we got so many fan comments asking us to talk to tourists. So today, I have brought you to a wonderful place, the Bandaranaike International Airport of the Democratic Socialist Republic of Sri Lanka. It's a wonderful place where people come and go, people do a lot of things. And as you can see, I am in the airport lounge, and on my right hand side, I have the departure terminal, and on my left hand side, I have the arrival terminal. So today, I will talk to some tourists and try to understand what their experiences are in coming to our country. Let's see, is there somebody? Okay, sir. Sir, excuse me, sir. Can I talk to you for a couple of minutes? We're doing a small talk show.
Yes.
Sir, can you tell me your name and where you're from, sir?
My name is Almari. I'm from Lebanon.
Oh, Lebanon, wow, beautiful country, what a beautiful country, sir. Today I want to ask you, sir, what are the beautiful experiences you got, and how many days did you spend, and what was your experience with our beautiful country, the pearl of the Indian Ocean?
I came with my friends, five of them, for a 4-day trip to Sri Lanka. So first day, my guides took us to Anuradhapura, your ancient capital, okay? Then I saw some, you know, quite big structures, Buddhist structures, okay? Then I asked my guide, what are those? Then he told, those are white pyramids, okay? Like in Egypt. So then I looked for camels. So I was here, no? But no camels, only beef. No beef, cows, sorry. Okay? So then the next day, we visited to Arudangwe Beach.
Oh, beautiful.
But unfortunately, it was the off season. So no, what do you call?
Surfing.
No surfing, no jet ski, nothing. Okay, then we came back to hotel room. The next day, we were walking in the beach. The only interesting thing that happened, my friend, Mario, showed me, Almari, look, that's a crab. So I looked at crab all day and came back to room again.
Wonderful,
yeah. So then the last day we came back to Colombo, you know, but that's never, in Lebanon we party every day, Monday to Friday, skit, you know. So we went out to find a bar or a club. So unfortunately it was a Tuesday. So no club was open.
Bad day.
Yeah. So no club was open, so Colombo was some sort of sleepy. So we had few drinks and we came back in a tuk-tuk. You know, 5,000, it took me 5,000.
Hi guys, I don't know you guys have believed or not, like my friend Peter said, Sri Lanka is the number one tourist destination in the world. But is it real? Too much of tourists have come to Sri Lanka, but they doesn't know where they're going to go. Actually, seems like this person came to Sri Lanka for adventure work. He came from that country like Middle East country. And that kind of people are too much like adventure work. But he went to somewhere else. Now I'm going to tell Sri Lanka two authentic area of the country. One is coastal area. We have a lot of adventure things, different adventure places. You see, this area, most of the area, we can reach within 2.5 hours. We have expressway from Kapanai, and we can reach Gom, Magar, Hambang within 2 hours. No improvement. We have diving, fishing, jet ski, surfing, fighting ski, lot of ski. If you go to enter it, there are ample of places. Actually, and other thing I'm going to explain, in the middle of the country, there also we have a lot of place and authentic place. It's totally different with coastal area. And weather condition, everything is different. If you want, then we have rafting, hiking, sleeping, and whatever, camp, lot of things are there. But you know that this kind of people came to Sri Lanka for spending money, their money. We should know how to get that money from them. But unfortunately, our government don't have any clear policy to, clear vision to get the money from them smoothly. Because of that, we are losing too much of foreign government. I'm not going to waste your time anymore. That's for the TV.
Oh, so this tuk-tuk guy took 5,000 rupees per 1 kilometer. But anyway, I'm rich, so I paid, no worries. So I'm telling you, country is very beautiful, but you know, if you have some adventure and fun stuff like Thailand, I will come again. Next time I will see, okay? So my point is late, so I'm going, okay?
Thank you very much, sir.
Okay, have a good one.
Yalla habibi, sir, yalla habibi. And also, audiences, everybody, live audience, you're joining me here today at the Bandarbek International Airport Lodge. I have to mention our main sponsor and co-sponsor, Saku and Jitu. They are helping us a lot today with our program. On top of that, I would like to also look for another tourist. Let's see who we can talk to. Yes, there's a beautiful lady coming. Hello, madam. Madam, we are doing a small talk show. Can we talk to you for 2 minutes?
Sure.
Madam, can I ask for your name?
I'm Sita.
Oh, Sita. Sita is a very famous person. Madam, did Ravana kidnap you?
No.
No, different Sita. Okay, where are you from, madam?
I'm from India.
Oh, India. Shah Rukh Khan, Salman Khan, madam.
Yes, you are right.
Yes, we are big fans, madam. We are big fans. We are neighbors, actually. So I want to ask you, madam, what kind of experiences did you have in our country? What did you come and what did you fall in love with? Can you share your story with us?
So I'm an archaeology student. So yeah. So my purpose of to visit Sri Lanka is to understand how this India culture came to Sri Lanka. And this is my first visit to Sri Lanka. I like Sri Lankan food very much, especially manioc, sambal, and kothu. I really like them. But actually, I plan to stay here for months, but I couldn't stay here for a month. And also, I plan to visit so many historical places, but I could only visit three places, Polonnaruwa, Anuradhapura, and Jaffna, because I didn't get a proper guide. And due to language barriers, I couldn't talk to much people. And you know, some train drivers, they charged a lot from me. And I noticed some of these notice boards are also not clear. They didn't give proper information to me.
Anybody knows the seven kingdoms of Sri Lanka? Raise your hand if you know. Seven kingdoms of Sri Lanka. Okay, very good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Anybody knows the seven kingdoms of Westeros? Game of Thrones? Interesting. So we know better about Game of Thrones than our history, right? That's a serious problem when it comes to tourism also. What we could identify is we have seven kingdoms and we have a history of 2,500 years. But still we are exploring that well enough to actually get more revenue from the tourism. Answer is no. Which is because we don't have a proper plan as a government or as people. Even as people. So this is the solution we are proposing to the government and the community. We have identified three pillars. First is religious people who are now very busy with giving voice cut to politicians. Second, people are archaeologists who are really busy with doing their day-to-day activities but not really doing research on this our history. And the third pillar is architects and scientists. Why scientists? It is because we are talking about one Mahasaya. We we are talking about Parakram software, but anybody actually did a research about what is the inside technology there? Anyone found out? Answer is no. So why can't we use that tech to leverage our revenue into a research? This is what Egypt is doing. This is what Italy is doing. Why Sri Lanka can't? Let's take an example, Thailand. And the Theravada Buddhist country, right? Their revenue is actually 53 billion from tourism. Sri Lanka, we are talking much about 250,000 history, but it's still revenue is 4 billion. So we need to identify what are the gaps and we need to improve on that. Second thing is culture. So we are talking about culture very much, right? When we somewhat attack our culture, we are like, we are very furious, right? We want to protect it. But actually, are we actually using that to leverage our revenue? Answer is no. I think we should look at that also. There's a lot to say, but we have time to leverage. So let's go to back to CK and see what is happening next.
Oh, thank you, madam. Thank you very much for joining with us. I'm a big Shah Rukh Khan fan, madam. Thank you. So we have been talking to people who are leaving the country, who have experienced the country. I also want to go to the arrival terminal. Let's see who we can find there. Madam, we're doing a small talk show. Can I talk to you for a couple of minutes, please? To start with, what is your good name? Something wrong? There is nothing wrong here, madam. This is Sri Lanka, madam. We have so many good politicians. How can anything go wrong, madam?
Something wrong.
Okay, that's your name, madam. Sorry, madam. Beautiful name, madam. Madam, can I ask you, what did you come to Sri Lanka for and what are the experiences you are hoping to get?
Actually, I came to Sri Lanka with my husband for a holiday. I really love my life. Various TV programs, I got to know that Sri Lanka is a very famous place for wildlife sanctuary, like Yala. And here we have elephants, leopards, and whales, and bird species. So I think that I can get marvelous photographs of the rich. But this is the brooch, I don't see any of my interest.
Don't worry, madam. Can I set you up with the best guide in the country, madam? Sika. Camera, please. Sika, can you? This is a new tourist entering the country. Tell her how you can help her.
Right. Madam, I think you have came to the best destination as a tourist. So, Sri Lanka has been well known for the high level of diversity and wildlife. So it is the only one place in the world that you can see the elephants, the leopards, and the coastal areas, and as well as the more species of the birds, all those things. So Sri Lanka has a very largest gathering, the Asian elephant at the main area. You can see. And as well as the concentration of the wild leopards in Jala, and the blue whales in the Trincomalee and the Melisse, as well as out of 400 bird species, 32 of that endemic to Sri Lanka. So as you can see them in the Singoraja and the Kumana as well. So I think it is with these superlatives and the varied faunas, it's really experiencing the need for you. So let me guide you. So with your tourist arrival shows.
Madam, he will help you, madam, for sure. He will charge very little, madam. You pay everything. And madam, on top of that, I want to ask you, but hold on for a second. Once again, the idea is this. As all of you audiences, Sri Lanka is the country that is called as the paradise on earth. We have the largest, most untapped potential in terms of tourism. And nobody knows this country as much as you do. And you all, and we all, can play an active participation in developing and contributing to tourism in Sri Lanka. On that note, madam, I couldn't ask you, where are you from, madam?
Wuhan, China.
Wuhan, wow, madam. Oh my God, madam. Ladies and gentlemen, if I'm alive, I'll see you next week. Thank you.